The panel on The View mocking Vice President Mike Pence for saying that he talks to Jesus. Watch.
I think when you have a Mike Pence that now sort of puts this religious veneer on things and calls people values voters, I think we're in a dangerous situation. I'm a faithful person, but I don't know that I want my vice president, speaking in tongues and having Jesus speak to
me. Like I said before,
I don't know if I want that.
It's one thing to talk to Jesus. It's another thing when Jesus talks to you. It's called mental illness, if I'm not correct.
I'm
hearing voices.
Pastor Robert Jeffress is a senior pastor at First Baptist Church and a faith advisor to President Trump. Pastor Jeffress, thanks for coming on this morning. I'm sure that you're having a reaction just hearing that again. What is it?
Well, look, let's just go ahead and say what we all know is true. If Joy Behar had attacked a devout Muslim for his faith, ABC would have fired her in a nanosecond. But you know, to the left, when it comes to attacking conservative Christians, it is always open season. And you know, I'm often asked, why is it that evangelicals supported a secular candidate like Donald Trump by the largest margin in history? This is the reason. Christians are tired of being bullied for their faith in the public square. They wanted an administration who would respect rather than ridicule their beliefs. And in many ways, the election of Donald Trump and Mike Pence was a reaction against these kind of despicable attacks upon people's faith.
Why do you think that they have such a problem with the vice president and his beliefs?
Well, scratch beneath the surface or read what they've said in the past, and it's very clear. Mike Pence has committed the unpardonable sin when it comes to the left, and that is he still maintains the personal belief that marriage should be between a man and a woman. And look, everybody doesn't agree with that perspective. He understands that, but you can hardly call that an extreme perspective when it's the belief of the three major world religions, Christianity, Judaism, and Islam, which have taught that for years, thousands of years. And look, this once again shows the hypocrisy of the left. The left cries for tolerance, tolerance, and yet they are the most intolerant people when it comes to beliefs with which they disagree.
You also have a prediction to make about the next presidential election if the left continues to keep up their ridicule of conservative Christian beliefs.
Look, I told President Trump last week he has become the most faith-friendly president in history, and his selection of Vice President Pence is just one example of that. But if Joy Behar and her ilk continue these kind of unfounded attacks, you're going to see President Trump reelected by a landslide in 2020, and you're going to see Vice President Pence become President Pence in 2024. My prediction.
I've got to leave it there, Pastor, but final word to you. Mike Pence and his response to this. We have not yet seen or heard a response from him. Do you think he should respond?
My guess is you will hear a very gracious response in some form very soon.
Pastor Jeffress, thanks for coming on this morning.
Thank you.